Let's review the serial manufacturing line example. Parts arrive at the rate of 60 per hour. We have three phases for the manufacturing process. First, there's machining. Next, there's grinding. And finally, packaging. The machining step requires approximately 45 seconds per part. The grinding step requires approximately 55 seconds per part. And the packaging requires approximately 63 seconds per part. Additional complexities in this manufacturing process include that 10% of the machine parts are going to need to be remachined, and 10% of the ground parts are going to be deemed bad, and we're going to have to dispose of those bad parts. Now first let's look at the inter-arrival time. Try to determine the inter-arrival time for this process. We've been given the arrival rate of 60 parts per hour. To determine the mean inter-arrival time, it's simply 1 over lambda, the arrival rate. That's 1 over 60 per hour times 60 minutes per hour, and we get the resulting 1 minute on average. We'll model the inter-arrival times with an exponential distribution. And again, recall that inter-arrivals refers to the time between arrivals. For machining, we've been given an average service time of 45 seconds. We will model this also with an exponential distribution. For grinding, we've been given an average service time of 55 seconds. We will model this also with an exponential distribution. And packaging, we've been given an average packaging time of 63 seconds. And also we will model this with an exponential distribution. Let's build a simulation model for the serial manufacturing line example in Simio. We'll have one source, three servers, and two sinks. The first sink will be for good parts, and the second sink will be for bad parts. And the model entity, the entity type that we'll have, will be parts. Let's name that entity type parts. We'll name the first server machine. We'll name the second server grind. We'll name the third server package. Now for the sinks, let's name the first sink good for the good parts. And let's name sink 2 bad for the bad parts. Next, let's add the connectors. We'll connector from the source to machine, connector from machine to grind, a connector from grind to package, a connector from package to good. We'll also need a connector from grind to bad for the bad parts. And then we'll also need a connector from the output of machine. Click, click, click back to the input for machine for those parts that require remachining. Now let's update the properties for the source. Let's make sure that the entity type is the parts entity. The inter-arrival time, we'll set this to the exponential distribution with a mean of 1 minute, and we'll make sure the units are set to minutes, which they are. Now we'll go to the machine. We'll set this to be a exponential distribution, and this one will be with a mean of 45 seconds. I'll put 45 here, And then we can change the units from minutes to seconds. Next, we'll set the grind. It will also be with the exponential distribution with a mean of 55 seconds. So again, we'll need to change from minutes to seconds. For package, we'll also set this to the exponential distribution with a mean of 63 seconds. Again, we'll change the units from minutes to seconds. The next thing we need to do is to set the selection weights. For the grind, we have 90% of the grind need to go to packaging. So we'll set the selection weight here from 1, we can set it to 90, or you can set it to 0.9, with the other one 0.1, or in this case what I'm going to do is set the selection weight to 90 on this connector and 10 on the other. We'll also set up the selection weights from machining to remachining and to grind. So 90% will be good and not require remachining. So we'll put 90 on the selection weight for connector 2 to grind. And then we'll put 10 on the selection weight for the connector that goes to remachining. Let's try running this model. To run, we'll put the start type to start at the current second. We'll do the ending time to be 100 hours. The run length. And now if we perhaps increase the speed factor and try running this model. We can see the parts going through the system. Let's stop the current run for now. Next, let's create an experiment, and we'll create some experiment responses and also response results using the SMORE plots, the Simio measure of risk and error plots. Click New Experiment. We'll set 100 replications. Now let's add some responses. Click Design, then Add Response. Click on the response, we'll change the name to MUtil for machine utilization, and then we'll specify the expression, which will be machine.capacity.scheduledutilization. Now let's create another response. This one we will call GUtil for grind utilization. We'll specify the expression grind.capacity.scheduledutilization. Let's create another response. will be the utilization for packaging. It's called PUtil. The expression here will be the package server object, package.capacity.serverUtilization. Rather, scheduled utilization. Let's create two more responses. One will be for time in system, and one will be for the number in system. For time in system, we'll use TIS for short. Time in system. The expression we'll use here will be parts.population.time in system. This one will be dot average. We'll set the unit type to time, and in this case, we want to have the display units in minutes. Now we'll go back and create a fifth response. This response will be for the number in system. We'll call this NIS for number in system. Then we'll use the expression parts.population.numberInSystem.average. Next, we'll run this experiment. We'll run the 100 replications. See, it's running down below 8%. Now 60%. And finally, 100%. Now to view the SMORE plots, the Simio Measure of Risk and Error plots, we simply need to select for each response. We can go to Response Results. And then from here, we have a drop-down menu, one for MUtil, one for GUtil, one for PUtil, one for TIS, time in system, and one for NIS, the number in system. And so the SMORE plots show us the mean, the circle. It shows us the median, this line. It shows us the mean confidence interval, the brown box. It also shows us the lower percentile. It also shows us the lower percentile confidence interval. It shows us the upper percentile, And then also the confidence interval for the upper percentile, as well as the min and the max. Hope this video was helpful in reviewing the steps that we took for building this serial manufacturing line, and hope you enjoyed the assignment of extending this model and creating some other simulation models using Simio.